Hello, boys and girls. Welcome back to Wonder Oblivion Lost with me. And we are back in Red Forest, and there's a controller somewhere nearby, and the game just crashed. And I wonder if it would crash again if I get into the controller range. I don't know if that happened. Oops. I wonder if that had anything to do with it. Or maybe it was just that the session had been going on for a while. And the... I don't know. Data had just been piling up to such extent that it started to collapse under its own... well, weight. If you can use such a word. Volume. Bulk. Okay, no. Controller alert yet. But I bet it is nearby. They usually hang around in this area. Unless the controller effect before was a bug. Is there another effect over there? Let me check. Unless it was a bug, that's why the game crashed. Ah, okay, now it's just the anomaly. They are deadly as they are comforting. As perverse as it sounds. Okay. And the agenda for today is still the same as it was in previous episodes. To hang around in somewhat dangerous areas. Somewhat dangerous areas where NPCs are prone to get killed. Artifact. Hello. Modificates on them. Okay, but where's the controller? Oh. Well, hello there. Didn't expect to see you. Rather deal with the controller sooner, because as brilliant as the interface fuck up is, it is also very tiring. Okay, I am not in the brain damage range yet. Shiny. Yes! Thank you. Better get further away from the weapons, because if they're normally triggers, then they will turn into projectiles. Oh, looks like I got paused the controller. So, or did I? These are the same dead ones whom I saw before. So I'm guessing that the controller started off somewhere here, hence all the zombie fight. And then moved on somewhere over there. Going to waste ammo on like regular zombies. And he has been picked clean as well. Let me check out my dead ecologist friends.
Easy.
See if I can add something. Some of the loot is still here. Okay. Wait. Is this like... Oh, it's a dead zombie. Okay. Developments after the recent blowout. Also, who goes there? Oh, zombie fight. Hello, boys. Whoa, there's like a whole gang. Yeah, they don't show up on the minimap. There is no use for that. Better use my eyes directly. Pistols this time. Right, and I wonder if any new monolith have shown up since I dealt with the last squad. Same bodies. Okay, level changer, here we go. I mean, here we come, or whatever. Oh! Right on cue. So, I'm gonna sit back here. And see what happens. Okay, I can't sit back too much. I have to be ready to loot. Skirmish. Right, keep the zone clean, of course. So I'm guessing that every now and again some duty and freedom squads will spawn somewhere here and then move on to Pripyat. So that's what I saw over there before. I think it would be useful to hang out somewhere over here, steady. Because this level changer is a dangerous place. Oh! And the Freedom will park their asses right here. Yep, that's the center of the zone for you. Dude! You need a tampon? You don't talk. Okay, I'm gonna squat in here just a little while. Try to eavesdrop if they have any good jokes. And enjoy the view. Very, very scenic tree. So, jokes? Anything? Guys? I'm getting restless already. I don't, generally I don't mind this sorts of sit and wait kind of missions, well, self-imposed missions, but if I'm recording then time has different flow and different value. Quiet in here for the moment. For now, I'm gonna check on those loners up the hill as well. Okay, so there are these. Okay, so there's two of them. Meaning the other two must have... telling the joke. So the other two must have... Hello? I'm gonna park myself between the anomalies. I don't want to shoot those barrels. Those might come handy. Of course, when they are shooting, not sucker sabotage. Always so satisfying when the bloodsucker is cloaked and you shoot at it and you see this little puff of blood show up practically from nowhere. city now. I'm gonna follow it. Since I'm going that way anyway. Fuck. Oh shit. Was it like a second one? Or what? Damn. Okay, I got overconfident here. Yeah, I think it's a second one. Maybe. Okay, let's see where my last save was. Nothing new from these zombies. Then freedom and duty should have their thing soon. I wonder if it's random when they show up or does it have anything to do with the player proximity. Maybe. Check out the level changer nonetheless. As I did before. Soul in the horizon. Okay, then back to the loners and the bloodsuckers. And quick save here so I won't have to crawl all the way back again. Hello? Okay, so that's the stuff I sold. Oh yeah, now it's his turn to tell the joke. Bloodsucker has to be somewhere around here. Maybe it hasn't come down the hill just yet. These are the old bodies. Oh! Loners here. And now he's here. Oh wait, do I have something I need to get rid of? No. So let's check this one. I bet there are tons of mutants crawling around after the blow out and whatnot. Hello? Okay, so looks like I have encountered both of them before. Oh, so one of the bloodsuckers is here apparently. Okay, take it slow. There was an anomaly here. Something that I have been killed by before. And it seems this particular one isn't here anymore. One regret about the radar. It's that, well, since I properly visited it only after the scorcher was off, I didn't get to see the effect in the sky. Because I don't think I have ever witnessed it properly, because during my first playthroughs in unmodded game, I had very low... oh, hello! Very low specs. Old computer. Windows XP. And another one. Okay. So I wasn't able to run the game with very high settings. Okay, that's an electro. Actually, I don't even want to hunt down the poltergeist too much. Let them roam free. But yeah, anyway, during my first playthroughs, I didn't have access to good graphics, and so my first experiences with the radar and the NPP, I didn't quite have the luxury of seeing proper night time, and the flares and effects weren't, well, they were there, but not too spectacular. So, anybody in here? Nope. Not anymore. Although I wouldn't be surprised if some monolith squads would return here. Oh, and a bloodsucker. There aren't any controllers active here right now. Oh. if there aren't any controllers, then I might give a little try to these code lock doors. Well, not these, but the ones that can actually be opened. No, not this one either. But others like it. Talking about jump scares. Never mind the mutants, it's the bucket that gets you. Okay, screenshot time. This is just so pretty. Maybe I left them alone because I didn't want those artifacts. Okay, let's see. Also check the folklore just in case. No numbers, no numbers. No numbers, I'm gonna read the ones later. Those are okay, these are just the same ones I remember from vanilla. So, diary then. Three, four, two. Gosh, I can't remember numbers, I have to write it down. Okay, this ain't it. So let's try with some usual. Usual magic. Shit. Fun fact, I have mapped the drop key. Under J used to be G, which was too close to the too close to F, so I would accidentally drop my weapon in crisis. So low crouching right now, so I'll try to replicate that finger gymnastics. Oh crap, I could have just waltzed in had I reacted faster. Aiming isn't even necessary. it's just a matter of many, many tries. Or just... Oh, fuck. And now I have dropped my weapon in there. Okay, gonna reload. A few times, then that's enough for today. Oh, this was okay. Hello. Okay. Who knows if there is a viewer in here? You might want to throw these to my head. Also, if I'm gonna try out the other door, which one is it? Okay, I have got all the loot. I'm pretty sure there's just rock behind this as well. Actually, I'm gonna use this instead. This is more expendable. Yeah, as I was gonna say before about this door interaction method, it's pretty random. You could succeed. Yeah, just the rock. You could succeed in just a few throws, or you could be spending a whole day on it, and still no avail. Okay, double check for anything I missed before. Okay, I might not have any real use for these artifacts, but loot is loot. Okay, not really, because one thing that I'm trying to sort of knowingly do is to reduce the shit that I carry around. This looks like a perfect place for another jump scare. So what will it be this time? We had a bucket. How about a fire extinguisher? Haha. Well, invisible crates will do. Invisible crates will do just fine. Ah, okay, so this one was, I think, the code that I did have. What was that? Separate manual save. Just for a good measure. Is that an artifact? No, it's a weapon. Hey. I would call an airstrike on two scanners if I could. Let me throw another one. But it felt good. Okay, let's try the grenade thing again. They go. Oh, there. Little fuckers. I hope they don't crash the game here. Ugh. I'm not even gonna search them. Skeleton in the corner is always such an encouraging sight. Is that a bloodsucker? No, I think it's just a light effect. I remember the episode that I recorded here when I sort of backwards triggered the radar stuff. And the thing was that, come on, that a blowout hit as I was in the control room, and after it was over, a whole variety of mutants joined the party, and mainly there was the controller, who was close enough to have absolutely devastating audio effect all the time, and I couldn't tell how bad it was only after the recording was up. So I tried to make some subtitles for it, and half of the time it was like something something something, so I say something here. Okay, save. Just in case, check the... No, don't load it. You're not supposed to use it for, like, normal purposes. Oh yeah, I took the scope off when I came inside. Whatever. So, diary, PD, data, target, did rocket, it's cloth, corner was silly. Oh no, just one of those. So. This riding on the wave of random reminds me of a recent article on gambler's fallacy. I think it was something like that people with certain brain damage do not fall into the gambler's fallacy, meaning if they almost win, they still don't get the illusion that they are closer to winning than they were before. So if it's a miss, if it's almost a hit, it's still a miss. And this is something to keep in mind with these door tackling tries, is that just because it almost worked doesn't mean it actually did work. I mean, doesn't mean that you're any closer to it working. Let's, okay, over here. Let me try from the hinges side for change. Okay, that's why I brought some spares. Like both of them? Okay. Yeah, so there seem to be some special clipping through spots. of course, with these kinds of side projects. The thing is, again, that when you're playing alone and when you're recording the time, fuck, time flows differently. And time has a different value. So I am not going to do this much longer. I kinda have this impression, I have developed this impression that these sort of lower corners, especially under the hinges, are more vulnerable when it comes to rifle lock picking or door picking. Actually, I don't know. I mean, at times I have got myself at very, very weird angles to hit the just correct spot or something. And actually, I don't even know if the sweet spot exists. Maybe it's just an illusion in the randomness. Just a few tries. What was that? So there are some spots that are dangerous, in that the weapon can bounce back with such a force that it kills you. Okay, door, have it your way. No, don't load it. I'm gonna drop this here. Maybe one day I'm gonna come back and experiment again. Just for fun. But for the moment I have had quite enough of this. Okay, also caution. Just because I killed some mutants on my way in, doesn't mean some other mutants haven't crept in on my way out. Once again, here is a perfect build up for a jump scare. Like, shit's been quiet for a while. I have dropped my guard somewhat. Not because I want to, but just because I can't hold on to the attention. Wait. Did I just come back? Oh fuck. No, I didn't. Okay. Had a moment of confusion there. So these pulsating lights are always a nice touch where creepiness is concerned. Quick save, because we are almost out. Home stretch is a very delicate time. Yes. So we are out. There seems to be nice weather going on. And nobody's around. Oh! I guess there are people around. I'm guessing loners. Shoot the zombie, not me. Reload. So, pistol runs out of ammo. Pick up another pistol then. Okay, creepy poltergeist is creepy. Can I at least search it? Okay, yeah. So, on with the looting. It's too much worn down. Now I'm gonna need all the ammo. Ooh, artifact. Groovy. Too worn down. Anybody I should be concerned about? Oh! He's shooting someone else, or someone else as well. Okay, check out these feathers first. Fuck. Killed by greed. Okay, so quickly. Oh, yeah. Quite over encumbered already. Okay, so there's a bit of a viewer situation going on. Okay, well, as usual. Away, and I'm gonna try to loot. Whoa! So much about that. Dude, what are you doing? Anyway, the plan was that I was gonna check out those two other bodies over there. But instead, I'm gonna end this episode on this grim note. Oh, hello, and the viewer joins the party. So, bye bye for now, and see you soon.